In the last class, some examples completed. Now write down example 16. What is example 16? Show that the points A7, 3, B6, 1, C8, 2, and D9, 4 taken in the tartar are vertices of a parallelogram. So, what is given? 4 vertices are given. We need to prove it is parallelogram. What are the 4 vertices? A7, 3, B6, 1, C8, 2, and D9, 4. We have to prove they are the vertices belongs to parallelogram. Okay, na? So, right, what is given first? Given, so important model. Already we covered this model in exercise 7.1. A 7, 3, B 6, 1, C 8, 2, D 9, 4. So what to prove? They are the vertices of a parallelogram. We have to prove it is a parallelogram. What is the important property belongs to parallelogram? In parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other. In parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other. So, what is the meaning of that? Midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. We have to prove that. Midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD, then it becomes parallelogram. So, to prove it is parallelogram, it is enough to prove that in parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other, means midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. Okay, na? So, one formula to write to prove it is a parallelogram, midpoint formula. Midpoint of AX1, Y1 and B X2, Y2 is P equal to X1 plus X2 by 2 comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2. So this is midpoint formula. P equal to X1 plus X2 by 2 comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2. So, find out, you know, the diagram of parallelogram. What is the diagram of parallelogram? You know, this is the diagram of parallelogram. A, B, C, D. First of all, it is a quadrilateral. We need to prove that that quadrilateral is parallelogram. First of all, ABCD is a quadrilateral. A 7, 3, B 6, 1, C 8, 2, D 9, 4. So, 4 sides are there. So, no need to find out length of the sides. It is enough to find out AC and BD. So, AC, BD. So, what are AC and BD? AC, BD are diagonals. AC, BD are diagonals. AC, BD are diagonals. Then, what to find out first? Midpoint of AC. Next, midpoint of BD. Then, so, find out midpoint of AC, BD are diagonal. So, midpoint of AC, finding midpoint of AC, what is A? 7, 3, X1, Y1, what is C? 8, 2, X2, Y2. Why we are using midpoint formula? According to properties of parallelogram. Remember, then substitute P equal to X1 plus X2 by 2, 7 plus 8 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2, 3 plus 2 by 2. Then what we get? P equal to 15 by 2, 5 by 2. This is midpoint of AC. Similarly, find out midpoint of BD. Midpoint of BD. Midpoint of BD. So, what is the midpoint of BD? So, midpoint of BD. B is what? 6, 1. Let it be x1, y1. D is what? 9, 4. This is x2, y2. X1, y1, x2, y2. Again, substitute. P equal to 6 plus 9 by 2. X1 plus x2 by 2, comma. Y1 plus y2 by 2. Again, what we get? P equal to 15 by 2, comma 5 by 2. 15 by 2, comma 5 by 2. So, till now, what is completed? First of all, midpoint of AC completed. Then, midpoint of BD completed. Then, what is your observation? Both are equal. Here, midpoint of midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. Midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. So, according to properties, it becomes parallelogram. Therefore, A, B, C, D are the vertices of a parallelogram. Parallelogram. A comma B comma C comma D are the vertices of a parallelogram. So this is the procedure to prove it is a parallelogram. How to prove it is a parallelogram? Shortcut. Use midpoint formula. First of all, it is a quadrilateral. Use midpoint formula. This is midpoint formula. X1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Then AC comma BD are diagonals. According to properties, find out diagonals only. Midpoint of AC. So x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. 15 by 2, 5 by 2. Midpoint of BD, B 6, 1, D 9, 4. Again, x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. 15 by 2, comma 5 by 2. So, what is our observation? Midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. Therefore, so according to properties, it is a parallelogram. Therefore, A, B, C, D are the vertices of a parallelogram. So, this is a simple method to prove it is a parallelogram. So, this is example 16. Now, see example 17. Example 17 is so example 17 is if the points, if it is also important, if the points, if the points A 6 comma 1, A 6 comma 1, B 8 comma 2, C 9 comma 4, and then D P comma 3, small p comma 3 are the vertices of a parallelogram. Are the vertices of a parallelogram. अवलोकनम टेकन इन आफ्टर फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ पी फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ पी सो सो दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम एग्जांपल 17 इफ द पॉइंट्स ए 6 कॉमा 1 बी ए 6 कॉमा 1 बी 8 कॉमा 2 C 9 comma 4 and D P comma 3 are the vertices of a parallelogram. It is given. They are the vertices belongs to parallelogram. Then find the value of P. First point 6 comma 1. Second point 8 comma 2. Third point 9 comma 4. Fourth point something is missing. P value we need. Find out P comma 3. So they are the vertices belongs to parallelogram. Find the value of P. So you can draw the diagram of parallelogram directly. It is granted. So ABCD is a parallelogram. Very clear. It is a parallelogram. So they are the vertices of a parallelogram. First point A 6 comma 1. Second point B 8 comma 2. Third point C 9 comma 4. Fourth point D P comma 3. So they are the four vertices. AC is a diagonal. BD is a diagonal. So two diagonals are there. It is a parallelogram. Then find the value of P. Solution. Right, what is given? Given. First one A 6 comma 1 second one B 8 comma 2 third one C 9 comma 4 fourth one D small p comma 3 so they are the four vertices belongs to parallelogram ABCD is a parallelogram this is the information given So we need to find out p value. Small p equal to question mark. P value how much? So what we use? You know the properties of parallelogram. In parallelogram, so what is the important property belongs to parallelogram? In parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other, right? Use that property only. So in parallelogram. Diagonals bisect each other in parallelogram diagonals bisect each other what is the meaning of bisect you know meaning of bisect is midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD that is the meaning so what is the meaning of bisect implies midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD use midpoint formula so write midpoint formula midpoint formula so midpoint of A x1 y1 and B x2 y2 is P equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2 then we need to apply midpoint formula for both the diagonals AC and BD first apply midpoint formula for AC Then apply midpoint formula for BD. So first A. So what is A? 6 comma 1. Let it be x1 y1. C. 9 comma 4. This is x2 y2. Then apply for BD also. What is B? 8 comma 2 x1 y1. What is D? P comma 3 x2 y2. directly apply formula. First apply midpoint formula for AC, then apply midpoint formula for BD. So what is midpoint formula for AC? X1 plus X2, 6 plus 9 by 2, comma 1 plus 4 by 2. Then BD, 8 plus P by 2, comma 2 plus 3 by 2. Then 15 by 2, this is 5 by 2. Then 8 plus P by 2, 5 by 2. Then two ordered plates equal. Let us equate corresponding elements. Equate corresponding elements. Equate corresponding elements. Let us equate them. Let us equate first to first. Means 15 by 2 equal to 8 plus 3 by 2. 15 by 2 equal to 8 plus 3 by 2. 2 to cancel. 15 equal to 8 plus P. 15 equal to 8 plus P. 8 is moving. P equal to 15 minus 8. P equal to 7. Therefore, P equal to 7. So, see the problem again. 4 vertices are given. First one A, 6, 1. Second one B, 8, 2. Third one C, 9, 4. Fourth one D, P, 3. It is a parallelogram. It is granted. P value how much? What the important property belongs to parallelogram? In parallelogram, diagonals. So what are the diagonals? AC, BD. Diagonals bisect each other. What is the meaning of that? Midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. Then midpoint formula AX1, Y1 and BX2, Y2 is P equal to X1 plus X2 by 2, comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2. Apply midpoint formula for AC and BD also. What is X1? 6 plus what is X2? 9 by 2. What is Y1? 1 plus what is Y2? 4 by 2. Similarly BD, 8 plus 3 by 2, 2 plus 3 by 2. Then 15 by 2, 5 by 2. 8 plus 3 by 2, 5 by 2. Then two ordered planes equal means equate corresponding elements. What is the first element? 15 by 2. Here what is the first element? 8 plus P by 2. 2 to cancel. 15 equal to 8 plus P. Then 8 is moving. P equal to 15 minus 8. P equal to 7. Therefore, P equal to 7. So today, both the problems belongs to parallelogram. In example 16, we are proving it is a parallelogram. In example 17, it is given it is a parallelogram. Then we are finding the value of P. Okay, now in the next class, we see some more examples. HW is example 16, example 17, one time. Thank you, students.